Shalom. I want to start off by giving all praise, glory, honor due unto Yahweh, Hashem, Yahusha, Hashem, Rakakodash. Double honors to the apostles and elders and great millstone. With no respect to the brother teaching and preaching the truth all over the globe worldwide. I'll come back at you with another lesson. And this lesson do not have a particular topic, but we just going to be rolling in the spirit in this lesson. You know what I'm saying? Whatever, you know, topics that comes to mind, we're gonna filter them through the scriptures. And I pray that your brothers and sisters be edified with this lesson, you know, through the power of the spirit. You know, and one of the things that, you know, that worth being mentioned is that, you know, we have to go into the straight gate. And by going to the straight gate, you know, things are going to be tighter. And, you know, as things start to become tight, you know, as you look at what's going on in the world, you know, through the news, you see people that are bugging out. You know, they're losing their mind. They, you know what I'm saying? They, you know what I'm saying? Losing their mind. They're bugging out because they do not really know what's going on. And because they don't know what's going on, you got people that you know what I'm saying, they trying everything in their power, you know, to try to save a kingdom, as you know, as it's been prophesied that it's gonna fall. Because if you go to 2 Ezra 6:9, well, I'm gonna pull it up real quick, give me one moment. You go to that particular scripture, it's been prophesied that this kingdom is going to come to an end. You know what I'm saying? It's been prophesied that. But let's get it real quick. You know what I'm saying? 2 Ezra 6. We'll get 9 as well, but we're going to go ahead and start with 6 first. And we won't start at 7, but the point is in 9. And it reads, it said, "Then answer I and said, what shall be the parting asunder of the times? Or when shall the end of the first and the beginning of it that followeth? And every great prophet of Yahweh Shem Al-Shah had always asked a question about when the end is going to come. Even when Yahusha was on the scene, you know, the first time, you know, in the Roman Empire, you know, they were asked when, you know, in Salaki, in Acts 1, they asked him, would thou at this time restore again the kingdom to Israel? You know what I'm saying? But, you know, that's another lesson for another day, but let's continue. You know, and it reads, this is 2 Ezra 6:8. And he said unto me, from Abraham unto Isaac, when Jacob and Esau were born of him, Jacob handheld first the heel of Esau. For Esau is the end of the world, and Jacob is the beginning of it that followeth. And when you understand the scriptures, you know what I'm saying, you understand prophecy that this man's kingdom is going to fall, because we just read that Esau is the end of the world, and Jacob is the beginning of that followeth. And what kingdom that we're in now? You know, let's get another scripture. You know, proves you that we are in this man's kingdom. You know what I'm saying? Let's get a very familiar scripture that comes out a lot. And it's prevalent to the time. You know, and this is 9:24. It reads, the earth is given to the hands of the wicked. He covered the faces of the judges thereof. If not, where and who is he, and who's ruling the world right now? The seed of the wicked, which is Esau, even the so-called white man. He's in rulership right now. That's the reason why we read 2 Ezra 6:9, tell you that Esau is the end of the world, and Jacob is the beginning of it that followeth. And this man's kingdom has been destined to fall, man. And as you see that going on, you had people that are they're bugging out because of it. You know what I'm saying? They're bugging out, and they're trying everything that they can, to try to save this man's kingdom. And why is that? Because it's been prophesied that it's going to happen. And it also has been prophesied that Yahweh HaShem Al-Shah is visiting the world, which he made. And we're going to get that in 2 Ezra chapter 9, starting at the first verse. And it reads, "He answered me then and said, Measure thou the time diligently in itself. And when thou seest part of the signs pass, which I have told thee before, then shalt thou understand that it is the very same time wherein the highest will begin to visit the world which he made." And we see Yahweh HaShem Al-Shah is visiting the world which he made. And how is he doing it? First, he will tell you. Therefore, when there shall be seen earthquakes and uproars of the people in the world, then shalt thou well understand that the Most High spake of those things from the days that were before thee, even from the beginning. And you see uproars and all types of plagues, uproars of the people and earthquakes, and you see plagues that are coming up on the world. And that shows you right there that Yahweh HaShem Al-Shah is visiting the world which he made through those plagues. And you see in the minds of the people, they losing their mind because they do not have the wisdom and knowledge of Yahweh HaShem Al-Shah. You know what I'm saying? Because the scripture said in Isaiah chapter 33, verse 6, says that wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy times. And when you understand that scripture, you understand having the words of Yahweh HaShem Al-Shah will give you stability. Because if we just go by what we see, what's going on around us, you know what I'm saying, it will cause you to lose your mind, because there's a whole lot of things that is going on around us. And we saw everything that was going on around us all at once. A lot of us want to make it, man, because it's a whole lot of things that are going on. You got not only you got the plagues, and you got the pestilence that's going on, but you also got enchantments. You got sorceries. You got the left hand magic is working at an all time high on the minds of the people. And then you got people that are bugging out. Even you got particular Israelites that they know about this truth. You seeing them bug out at a high level. You see them teaching the gospel that goes against Yahweh HaShem Al-Shah. You know what I'm saying? They took the bag. You know what I'm saying? They want to for this particular kingdom. Because they do not have the spirit the Yahweh HaShem Al-Shah, because the whole time they want to forward this man's kingdom, because they do not believe that there's gonna be a kingdom greater than this one that we're living in now. So what these devils are gonna do, what these people wanna do, the next thing they're going to do is they're going to come after the men of the Lord. Because they see that Yahweh HaShem Al-Shah is visiting the world which he made. You got to be in the spirit to understand that. You got to, study to show thyself approved, to study the gospel, and to, have the spiritual eyesight to see what's going on around you. Even when you watch the news, you see particular things that you can filter out through the scriptures, and understand that it's prophecy that these things are going to happen. You even got this devil is coming down with great wrath. You got him pushing, that thing, and sooner or later that thing is going to turn to the MOTB. Because these devils they know they have a short time, and they going to, you know, come with everything that they got. You know what I'm saying? But it's going, sooner or later, it's gonna come to the point that it's gonna come to the point that the devil just gonna come down with the sword. You know, no ifs, and buts about it. He's gonna come with that sword. And because he's upset, he's pissed, because he knows that his kingdom, you know what I'm saying, his kingdom is coming to an end. And so by his kingdom coming to an end, he knows that the same people whom he oppressed and made their lives a living hell, you know, those same people are going to be the ones that's going to be ruling over him in the kingdom of heaven. You know what I'm saying? You got all these things that are going on. You got the devil mad. You know, he's raging. He's upset. And you got the people of this world, you know what I'm saying, that not that they're let, you know what I'm saying, they're bugging out because they seeing that this very kingdom that they love and they really trust in, they seeing it come to an end. You know what I'm saying? Even you got Israelites who love this kingdom, they're bugging out. You know what I'm saying? They bugging out because of fact of the matter. If you ask an average Israelite about the world to end, they'll tell you they don't want to end because they got to, you know, see their children growing up. You know what I'm saying? They want to live, you know, they want to live their life to the fullest and all these things. But at the end of the day, this is the most vilest kingdom that we ever lived in, man. This kingdom is very vile. It's very wicked. You know what I'm saying? And this kingdom has to go down, man. But if you ask the average Jake, you know, they want this kingdom to stay, you know, stay standing. They want this kingdom to go back to normal. But guess what? It's never going to go back to normal because it's prophesied. It's prophesied that this kingdom is going to fall. And it's prophesied that Yahweh Shem HaShah is visiting the world which he made. And you can see it through, you know, the minds of the people. You can see that the people is oppressed, man. Because if you get Proverbs chapter 29, roughly around verse 2, and we're going to get there, we're going to show you that who's ruling right now. You know what I'm saying? Proverbs 29 and verse 2. And it reads, when the righteous are in authority, the people rejoice, but when the wicked bear rule, the people mourn. And you're going to see that the people right now are in a state of mourning. You know, you got riots all over the place. You got this quote-unquote virus is killing, you know, they're saying it's killing a lot of people. But the one that the virus really killing are those who took the juice. You know what I'm saying? But they're not going to come out and say it. They're going to say that it those that who have not took the juice are the ones that are dying. But no, it really the ones who are, you know, who took the juice, they the ones that are dying and still catching, you know, the virus. You know what I'm saying? But we know what rulership we in, you know, those in the spirit. We know that we are in a rulership of the wicked. You know what I'm saying? Because the wicked are the ones that are passing these unrighteous decrees. You can get that in Isaiah chapter 10, verse 1. They pass unrighteous decrees, you know what I'm saying? And they still, you know what I'm saying, trying to make life hard for you. So like it, they want to make life hard for you because, you know what I'm saying, if you don't comply to their wishes, you don't comply to their system, you know what I'm saying, they're going to make life hard for you. You know, it comes to a point that you're going to be thrown in jail if you don't take the juice. And you got particular people that are quitting their jobs because of, you know, they're required to take the juice. You know what I'm saying? Why are you saying all these things? What does all this have to do with prophecy? This is a fulfillment of prophecy that these things are happening. These things were prophesied that are going to happen. these things are prophesied that the devil gonna come with unrighteous decrees, man. You know what I'm saying? He come with those unrighteous decrees. And he passed laws that grieves the mindset of the people, particularly the Israelites, because this devil's whole target is to come after you Israelites. You know what I'm saying? That's his whole target. His whole target is to get rid of the Israelites, because if he can get rid of the Israelites, you know what I'm saying, he can you know what I'm saying, he believe that his kingdom, you know, it could be ruled for, he can rule forever, man. Because, you know, as I was watching one of the brother videos, you know what I'm saying, he was telling that, you know, China was, you know, trying to make a artificial sun. And then you had these particular devils that want to destroy the moon because what did the scripture say at you know, about the ordinances? Let's get that. Get it. So I can. So I can for it. Jeremiah chapter 31. And I'm going to start at 35. And it reads, "Thus said Yahweh, which giveth the sun for a light by day, and the ordinance of the moon and of the stars for a light by night, which divided the sea when the waves therefore roar. The Lord of hosts is his name." You know, Yahweh is his name. If those ordinances depart from before me, said Yahweh, then the seed of Israel also shall cease from being a nation before me forever. For thus said Yahweh, if heaven above can be measured, and the foundation of the earth searched out beneath, I will also cast off all the seed of Israel for all they have done, say Yahweh. So guess what? These devils know what they're doing. They say if these ordinances, you know, the sun, the moon, and the stars, you know, depart from Yahweh by Hashem Al-Shah, then the seed of Israel is gonna be cut off, man. You know, we cast off before Yahweh by Hashem Al-Shah, meaning that the seed of Israel, the so-called black Latino Native Americans, you will cease to exist before Yahweh by Hashem Al-Shah. If this devil disrupt the ordinances of Yahweh by Hashem Al-Shah, the sun, the moon, and the stars, and, you know, search out the earth, the depth of the sea, you know, so on and so forth. And this devil is trying to do that by, you know, scripture say he, you know, trying to accomplish a diligent search. Why is he doing this? He's doing this to try to wipe out the seed of Israel. Because if we know if he can accomplish a diligent search, he can wipe out the seed of Israel, but we know that's not going to happen. Because you still got the sun that is out now. You have the moon and the stars, you know, they're still out. So that means that the seed line of Israel is still in the earth. And this whole devil process, he wants to get rid of the seed line of Israel. You know what I'm saying? And these heathen nations do it where they want the name of Israel to be cut off forever. Because their name of Israel, it's the prince of the power, man. You know, we're the chosen people of Yahweh by Hashem Al-Shah, and these other nations don't like that. That's the reason why they want to cut off the name of Israel forever, man. You know, they want to cut off the name. And these people know what they're doing, man. You know, they talking about they want to make a diligent search. You know what I'm saying? They want to cut off the seed line of Israel. And you know what I'm saying? That's what these people want to do. And that's why he's saying the devil, he's just going to come with the sword, man. You know what I'm saying? And you got the minds of the people. You know what I'm saying? They're going to come out to the men of the Lord. Why is that? Because a lot of these people, they, you know what I'm saying, they don't want Israel to rule, man. They don't want the kingdom of heaven to be established. They want this particular kingdom to be set up. You know, because these people, they love their wickedness. You know what I'm saying? They love the wickedness of this society. They love it. They love to do what they want to do in this society. But this society ain't did enough but just fail them, man. Particularly Israel. You see, particularly Israelites, they know that this is a failing society, but yet, you know, they'll fight for this society tooth and nail. They'll fight to try to stay in a rulership that doesn't care about them. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, look at the mind of the people. You know, without Yah by Shem outside, look how they just, you know, they just losing their mind. You know what I'm saying? You got people just, you know, killing themselves, you know, every day, man. And, you know, you got people that murder one another in broad daylight. And you got all these scandals are coming out. You got all this wickedness that is going forth, man. And that's the reason why you got to keep yourself in Yah by Shem outside. And understand the scriptures, understand the time that you're living in. And these are not the times to faint, because like I say, when we'll begin to go through that straight gate, you know, and that straight gate is a position of difficulty, meaning that, you know, let's look that up. Because when you go into the straight gate, you got to understand that things are going to get tight. You know what I'm saying? Because going to this straight gate it's a task. And this is Matthew chapter 7, verse 13. It said, "Enter ye in at the straight gate, for wide is the gate and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction, and many there be which go in thereat." And a lot of these people going into that wide gate, because that wide gate to them is easier than going into the straight gate, because going to wide gate, it doesn't require work. You know what I'm saying? You can just be wicked and go into the wide gate. And that's why a lot of people going into that wide gate, because you know, to them it's easier than going to the straight gate, because the straight gate requires discipline, it requires sacrifice, you know what I'm saying? It requires, you know what I'm saying, a sacrifice from you. And what's that sacrifice? You know, you giving yourself up, you know what I'm saying, for the sake of the gospel. You know what I'm saying? For the sake of Yah by Shem outside, you giving up, you know, the things that you want to do. You know what I'm saying? The life that you want to live. You know what I'm saying? You give it up to follow the ways of Yah by Shem outside. And it's not an easy task, because when you going into that straight gate, you're going to stand out, man. And you're going to stand out, because you're not going to be like everybody else. You know, when everybody else is bowing to the beast system, you're going to stand out. You're going to stand up, and you're going to stand out. You're not going to follow the system. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? The system that the devil created, you know, to trying to get you to not follow Yah by Shem outside. You're going to bulk up against that system. You know what I'm saying? And as everybody else is bowing a knee, you know what I'm saying, and you know, everybody else is bowing the knee, you know, everybody else is being branded, you know, you're going to stand up, because the straight gate, it's a difficult gate to go through, you know what I'm saying? Because it requires discipline and it requires sacrifice. And those are two things that a lot of people are not willing to do. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, they're willing to do it, but they'll do it, you know, on the left-hand side. But, you know, doing it for the right-hand side, which is your house shot, a lot of people don't want to do it because they know they're going to have to give up, you know, this lifestyle in this society, you know, so on and so forth, man. And it's not an easy task, you know what I'm saying? Because these people ain't going to, don't want to give up, you know, the lifestyle, man. But let's go on to Matthew 7:14. And it reads, because straight is the gate, and narrow is the way which leadeth unto life, and few that be that find it. Because it says, because straight is the gate. You know, that straight gate is a very difficult gate to go through, because it's so straight that only one person could enter therein, man. You know, and you got to go through that straight gate by yourself. You know, because the scripture tells us to work out our own salvation with fear and trembling. You know what I'm saying? Going through that straight gate, you know, as I said before, it requires a sacrifice. And that's a sacrifice that a lot of people are not willing to do. You know what I'm saying? Because this sacrifice, it requires you to be mocked. It requires you to be scoffed at. It requires you to be ridiculed, you know what I'm saying, on a whole nother level. And this sacrifice, it requires a lot. And that's a sacrifice people are not willing to do. You know, they're not willing to take. Because guess what? They don't want to stand out, you know, and stand up for what is right in the eyes of Yahweh Hashem Al-Shah. They don't want to stand up for what is right. They don't want to stand up for the truth. And get what? And you stand up for the truth, you're going to have to be prepared to be ridiculed. And also, you're going to have to be prepared to even lose your life. Because going into this straight gate, you know what I'm saying, it's a sacrifice. And a lot of people won't do it. Because get what? You know, it requires for them to get something up. In particular, when you go on that straight gate, in particular in these times, when you're going into that straight gate, you know what I'm saying? You're gonna lose a lot of comforts, because as the devil coming down with the pressure, you know, for people to take that thing, and then sooner or later it's gonna turn to the MOTB. A lot of people not going to be willing to make the sacrifice for Yahweh Hashem Al-Shah, because that sacrifice is going to require you to be uncomfortable. And a lot of people don't like to be uncomfortable, and especially those that are of Israel, you know, because you got a lot of people there, a lot of Israelites that are teaching the truth. And then you see them, you know, in their ministry, you start to see them, you know, teaching wayward doctrines. You know, that is off. You know, you start seeing them talking about some, you know, you got to do what you got to do in order to survive. They'll tell you, you know, you got to take the, you know, take that thing in order to, you know, take care of you and your children. You know, they had no faith in Yahweh Hashem Al-Shah. The scriptures say that you're going to see these things, man, because, like I said, that straight gate requires a sacrifice. And that sacrifice, it, you know what I'm saying, it's very heavy, man. It's a very heavy sacrifice that you got to make when you stand up for Yahweh Hashem Al-Shah. Because did not the scripture say that if you build a building, you're supposed to count the cost? You know, roughly paraphrasing, being in this truth, you know what I'm saying, you got to count the cost, because being in the truth is a sacrifice. You know what I'm saying, knowing the words of Yahweh Hashem Al-Shah and to do them, it's a sacrifice. You know, you have to sacrifice, you know, in order to teach the gospel. You know, you got to, you know, teach, you know, regardless of what's going on in your life, you know what I'm saying, regardless of, you know, your loved ones, you know, turning their back on you, you know, people abandoning you, you still got to continue to do what you got to do. You know, in the will of Yahweh Hashem Al-Shah, meaning you continue to teach the gospel regardless. because it's a sacrifice. Did not Yahshua say in the scriptures that he did not come to send peace on the earth but a sword? You know what I'm saying? And that's that sacrifice, man. Because the words of Yahweh Shem Yahshua is to cause division. You know what I'm saying? In the word of Yahweh Shem Yahshua not bringing, you know, people together. It will bring the elect together, but I'm talking about, you know, it's going to cause division. You know what I'm saying? It's going to cause much division because when you're teaching the truth and when you bring the scriptures out, you have people that, you know, they act like that those particular scriptures don't exist. They're trying to explain them away. But that's part of going through that straight gate is to teach the words of Yahweh Shem Yahshua. And to teach them in sincerity and truth, you know what I'm saying? You're going to lose family members. You may lose your spouse. You may lose your children. You know what I'm saying? They'll turn their backs on you. You know what I'm saying? They even will plot to the point to have you even be put in prison. It coming to that point because the minds of the people are not for Yahweh Shem Yahshua. You know, therefore this world, therefore this kingdom, therefore this particular system, and a system that, you know, that is going to fail them at the end. You know what I'm saying? Because of the men and women and children of Yahweh Shem Yahshua is going to have the victory in the long run. You know what I'm saying? These people there, you know, they getting, you know, juiced up. They're going to take the MOTB. They think they're going to have the victory. They think they're going to avoid, you know, the judgment that's coming up on the earth. No, you're not going to avoid it. You know what I'm saying? It's coming up on the earth. And when it does, it's going to hit hard and heavy. And a lot of people are not going to be prepared for it because they think that, oh, I got, you know, juiced up. You know, I took the MOTB. You know, this scourge that is coming upon the earth is not gonna hit me. I'm gonna be good. I'm gonna be secure. But guess what? You're not gonna be secure. You're gonna get swept in that judgment because of, you know, you didn't have faith in Yahweh Shem Yahshua to stand up for what is right. Because standing up for what is right is a sacrifice. And that's a sacrifice that a lot of people are not willing to do. Because that sacrifice, it's, you know what I'm saying, it's a very heavy sacrifice. And it requires you giving up yourself. Just like Yahshua gave up himself to be that sacrifice for the children of Israel. You know, you're going to have to be that sacrifice for the sake of Yahweh Shem Yahshua to give up yourself, you know, to offer yourself up as a sacrifice. Meaning to offer up your time, offer up your energy, to do the work of Yahweh Shem Yahshua. Because a lot of people are not willing to do that. Because them doing that, you know what I'm saying, it, you know, they got to go through, you know, being laughed and mocked and ridiculed. You got to stand out, you know what I'm saying, and you got people that are not willing to do that. Particularly Israelites, they're not willing to do that. You know what I'm saying? Because, They love this world. They love this society. They love the things of this world. You know what I'm saying? They can't see anything past this particular rulership that we're in. Even though that you see that it's falling right before your very eyes, but you got particular people, they still trying to fight for this system. And guess what? At the end of it all, you're going to lose, man. You're going to lose if you fight for this particular kingdom. You're going to lose. Did not Yahusha say in the scripture, if this was of my kingdom, my servant will fight. You know what I'm saying? He said, if this was his kingdom, his servant, he'd have a servant to fight for it. But this is not his kingdom. You know, Micah 2 and 10 tells us to ride in the park. For this is not your rest. This is not our rest, man. This is not our kingdom. This is our captivity. When you understand scriptures, we're in captivity. You know what I'm saying? We're serving out the last bit of our captivity. You know what I'm saying? And being in that captivity, we're going to go through that straight gate. to lock it. Even the elect of the house of Israel are going to have to go through the fire. You know, that's in Zechariah chapter 13, verse 9. His elect, he had to go through the fire, and they're going to be tried. That's part of going through that straight gate. That's part of being that sacrifice. You're going to have to go through the fire. You got to go through all these trials and tribulations. You got to have to go through, because Yahushua went through it. And he offered himself up as a sacrifice. And if he did that, and he had to go through it, how much more those that are the elect, man? How much more we have to go through that sacrifice and be a sacrifice for Yahweh by Shem Al-Shah? You know what I'm saying? And that's what you got to ask yourself. You know, what is the cost of me being walking in the ways of Yahweh by Shem Al-Shah? You know, what will I have to lose in order to be a follower of Yahushua Mashiach? You know, you got to denounce the things that are of this world. You know, like the people celebrating the wicked pagan holidays and things of that nature. You got to make a bold stance and say that, you know what, I'm not going to do that, because Yahushua Mashiach said that's wicked and I'm not going to do it. So you got to make a stance against that. And you got to say, no, I'm not going to do it. You know, you may have, you know, your wife, your children, all these people don't understand it. And they look at you like you're weird, but guess what? That's a sacrifice. You know what I'm saying? You got to make yourself a sacrifice. You got to be willing to take a lot of L's on the chin in order to walk in the ways of Yahweh Hashem Al-Shah. But guess what? At the end of it all, you're going to have victory. At the end of it all, when Yahushua comes back with the host of heaven, which are the angels, and take down the wicked rulership, and you are the elect, you're gonna have the victory. You're gonna be beamed up in the chariot if you're still alive at that time. You're gonna be beamed up in the chariot, and you're gonna receive your crown, man. You know what I'm saying? You're gonna see that crown for standing up for Yahweh Hashem Al-Shah. You know what I'm saying? And you know what I'm saying? You're going to receive that honor and that glory alongside of Yahushua. You know what I'm saying? Alongside the rest of the men, women, and children, which are the elect. Particularly if you're the 144,000, which are men, the governing body, you really going to be on another level. But, you know, as you see in these things that are going on in the world, you know what I'm saying? You know, filter out through scriptures. Understand what time period that you're in. Understand that this man's kingdom is coming to an end. Don't be weary of what's going on, because Yahweh Hashem Al-Shah said that these things are going to happen. So you have to stand firm in the words of Yahweh Hashem Al-Shah and keep the faith. You know what I'm saying? And that's it for a lesson. You know, and I pray that you bless me, edify, Salaki, for being all over the place. But I want to give all praise, glory, and honor to Yahweh, Baal Shem, Yahweh Shah, Baal Shem, Rokakwadash, Shalom.